To the COVID situation now, and households and hospitals are clearly now the battleground in our fight against the infectious Delta variant. Authorities despairing that people are still visiting each other and spreading the virus, and that's having an impact on our health system.
In other times, our hospitals would now be under the strain of influenza cases. Delta has changed that.
There's absolutely no question that the hospital system is under enormous pressure across New South Wales.
In the latest cluster, at St George Hospital, a long-term cancer patient in the oncology ward became symptomatic and passed COVID to three other patients and two staff members.
The result of that, just in that one fairly small case, has taken out 80 health staff for the 14 days quarantine.
At Canterbury Bankstown, a ward also had to be closed because of a transmission. More generally, the number of COVID-positive cases requiring hospitalisation has risen to 447. 69 are in intensive care, with 24 on ventilators. Case numbers overall are down on yesterday, but of the 452 reported today, up to 351 were infectious in the community for all or some of the time. Sadly, a woman in her late 70s died at Westmead Hospital.
We envisage that case numbers in the next 2 or 3 weeks will bounce around and are likely to go up substantially. And we have to brace ourselves for that. But our key aim will be keeping people out of hospital and keeping people alive.
Apart from hotspots in western and southwestern Sydney, the crisis grows in western New South Wales. 18 new cases today in Dubbo, another in Broken Hill, after a man attended a funeral in Wilcannia. Most concerning, the majority of cases are members of the vulnerable Aboriginal community, leading the Commonwealth to send in reinforcements starting tomorrow.
We will be dispatching 5 ADF vaccination teams. They'll support vaccination, but where swabbing or other activities are required, they're highly mobile, highly flexible, highly trained.
5 medical OSMAT teams are also being sent to support hospitals. With 152,000 people tested in New South Wales yesterday, tales of delays in processing results are continuing to emerge. While some get results back in hours, others are waiting many days. Amanda Winchester badly injured her thumb while making soap for her gift box business last week. After emergency care at Nepean Hospital, she was scheduled for follow-up surgery this afternoon, but required a COVID test, which she had on Friday.
I was told that I would get the results back well before Tuesday, so I wasn't panicked. However, it's now Tuesday, and I haven't received my result.
Unable to show a negative result, Amanda was forced to cancel her surgery. Vaccinations are a better story. More than 5.2 million now administered in New South Wales. The Premier believes we're on track to have 70% of us double vaccinated by the end of October, 80% by mid-November. And after delivering grim news yesterday that the end of our life in lockdown would be delayed, a backtrack today and a little more hope.
Life will be much freer than what it is today once we get to 70% and 80%. It doesn't mean that we will let the virus be rampant in the community, no matter our number of cases, but it will be freer than what it is today.
More than 75% of all today's cases are those aged below 40, so the extra 530,000 doses of Pfizer promised to New South Wales will be targeted to 16 to 39-year-olds in the 12 key council areas of concern.
We are throwing absolutely everything we've got at getting those doses into arms over the next 2.5 weeks.
When it comes to where people are being exposed to COVID, that's still mainly occurring when people visit each other or go to work. And in the past few days, that's prompted a shift in reporting, with venues such as shops and supermarkets no longer appearing on the government's website of exposure sites.
So we're really trying to focus the public's attention on those where we believe there is a true risk. Venues or places where people have been in households, in other households, not their own, in workplaces, and high-risk settings such as hospitals, aged care facilities.
And that takes pressure off overwhelmed contact tracers at a time when there are more cases than ever to trace. Eddie Meyer, 9 News.
All right, let's go to breaking news. An aged care home in Blacktown is tonight in lockdown after a worker tested positive. The staff member at Blacktown Terrace Care Community is fully vaccinated. All residents are isolating in their rooms. Police are leaving no stone unturned in their compliance blitz across the state. 20,000 infringements have been issued in the past 2 months. And today, from Bondi Beach to Dubbo, officers were again out in force.
On the sands of Bondi, there's no escaping the watchful eye of police. New security cameras today looming large over the promenade, monitoring movements in yet another bid to enforce compliance.
Got to keep people safe, you know, and any measure's good, especially these days.
As long as you've got your mask on and you keep moving, then I think it's fair enough. As long as we can keep the beaches open, eh?
Yeah, I think it's great. Like, I think there's heaps of people, especially in areas like that, so it's good to be, like, aware of what people are doing.
In the past 24 hours, officers have paid a visit to more than 2,300 homes across the state, checking in and checking up on those in isolation.
That part of the contact tracing is going to be so important to make sure that people stay at home.
In Fairfield, one man who was meant to be isolating decided to take a drive to get some fresh air. Police say he pulled back into the driveway to find them waiting at the front door with a $5,000 fine.
And that person will continue to be checked on and make sure that they comply.
In Newcastle, a 22-year-old has earned himself a date with the courts, charged after he hosted not one, but multiple parties at his home during lockdown. It's resulted in at least three people contracting COVID. There were roadside checks in Dubbo. People lingering at park benches were ordered to move on. Two removalists trying to move office furniture via Lithgow were stopped and fined.
Turn around and head back to Sydney.
And at Westmead and Bass Hill, hundreds of cars were pulled over and questioned by police.
What's your reason for being out at the moment?
This driver didn't have an answer. Now they have a fine.
579 infringements have been issued in the past 24 hours. Police say one in five of those are people who are simply out and about with no good reason.
Policing will continue at this level, not just tomorrow, not just this week, but over the next 21 days.
So a hardline stance on policing, but the problem is the majority of cases are emerging when people breach the orders to visit one another, and cracking down on that is proving a difficult task for police. Lauren Tomasi, Nine News.
Police are getting on the front foot with murmurs of a new anti-lockdown protest planned for this weekend. Nine's Laura Tunstall is at Victoria Park for us this evening. Laura, what do you know?
Well, Pete, police are concerned about this planned protest here in Victoria Park on Saturday. It is being described as a rally for peace, freedom and human rights. But police are determined to shut it down and they're taking no chances. Today, issuing a number of public safety orders to certain individuals. We have video of one man being told he's banned from entering the CBD. Now, of course, the last time a rally like this was planned, police turned up in a huge show of force, setting up an exclusion zone around the CBD to stop the protest from happening. Police say anybody who turns up here to Victoria Park on Saturday will be fined or arrested. Pete.
Laura, thank you.